Hey, what's good, everybody? Welcome back to Tales of Berseria. As you can see, we are in prison again. No, I'm kidding, we're not really. I just thought it'd be a fun way to start the episode. But we are escaping the prison, because we have... We need to escape the prison. Artorias and his lackeys have attacked our secret fort base, Prison Titania. Tried to take the Therians from us, but we were too slick. We've already got the... Oh wait, do we have them? In theory, we already have the Therians. We found them all and sent them back to the ship. Hopefully they're safe. I don't know. We didn't send an entourage with them or anything. So I guess we'll find out. But it is time to break out of the prison. And because I keep dying in here, just do that really quick. Always a good thing to have a backup.
Will Artorias use an Armatus as well?
I don't know. It's hard to believe that the Abbey's leader would risk using an art that could end his own life, but...
The Shepherd's reputation would be ruined if he self-destructed over some botched formula. On the other hand, if the risk is based on the user's ability, then the Legates might not have any trouble.
So if Artorias were to try, he'd armatize with a Nominat.
Can an Empyrean be used as an Armatus? I'm not even sure Artorias can handle that.
He'll do it. Why else would he try to revive a Nominat?
But we're talking about an Empyrean!
He'll succeed. I'm certain of it. This is the Shepherd Artorias we're talking about here. Whether God or Devil stands in his way, he won't be swayed. That's who he is.
Velvet!
But it won't save him. He'll die by my hand. Empyrean or no Empyrean.
The phrase "die by my hand" kind of has like a whole new meaning to it when you consider her hand is like a giant human hand, you know? I mean, that's just me. I could be wrong. But it seems like it does have a different tone to it in that sense, doesn't it? Okay. Well, anyway. I guess we're not going to the front. We want to go back to where the ship is, our ship is, and our ship's in the back, which sucks because the save point technically is in the front. Whoever designed this dungeon needs to go back to school.
Here I come.
Let's go. Let's put the save point in the front and then never let them go near it. Then make the fights really hard. That way they'll die a bunch. It'll be great.
Killing flash.
But I'm this close.
I won't miss.
Form zero.
Thunder.
You think we'll even see Artorias? I mean, I know he's here, but will we actually see him, you think? It seems like they wouldn't have had him come out here if we weren't going to see him, so I guess we'll see him. What purpose does he serve?
I unleashed all my power. Maybe I overdid it.
That's not the out. Out is this way! Look, after 7 times getting lost in here, I'm finally getting my directions together. I get anxious when there's no safe spot. Thank goodness for the new quick save option. Yay, or not new.
Eisen, there's trouble. The enemy found the Von Eltia. Several enemy ships are heading this way right now.
Set sail, now!
I'm, glad we were able to save everyone.
There's no escape, Lord of Calamity.
Benwick, forget me. Take the Von Eltia and leave, now.
That's madness. What do you think you're doing?
If I don't take them down, they'll sink you from afar.
Raise anchor. We'll make it through somehow.
Aye, aye. But don't die. You hear me?
Crazy kids.
We're not going to die. We're going to kill.
Winds!
Lady Heaven, pierce mine enemies!
See this?
So, Lordic, I hate those archers. You know what? I hate those archers so much. I'm gonna go shoot that thing. Anyway, I think the archers are the thing that are really good at the target. To be honest, if you just leave them alone, they just do that nuky stuff. Very annoying. Anyway, so Lord of Calamity, right? Is that a nickname that's just gonna stick despite not wanting it to? Do you think Artorias is the first one to be like, we'll start calling him the Lord?
What do we do now?
We'll head to the front docks.
To steal an Abbey ship, I take it.
That's where the Abbey's main forces will be concentrated. And Lord Artorias should be there too.
All the better.
But we still don't have a way to fight Enominat.
I told you, if you want to die, do it alone.
I'm not asking you to come with me.
Use me.
Percival.
Don't worry. Griffin got away. If you use me as a hostage, you should be able to steal a ship.
I owe you one for this. But don't expect gratitude.
I don't.
Looks like this is our best and only bet.
Horizon and, whoa,
we're going to the front docks to escape. Don't forget that.
I know. Arthur's first maxim, right?
Not sure I followed that conference, but
move it or die.
Is it just me or like Aizen and Velvet starting to hit the point where they're I don't know, they've always had like a little tension though. There's always been kind of a little line of like, how far am I willing to go? Versus how far are you willing to go? Versus how crazy are we?
Sorry to cut you down.
I mean, technically, he could have run off on his own. He didn't have to tag along. Right? But he's got a point. Like, they're very likely to die now. He should have just gone on the boat with Benwick. He should have been like, I'll leave this to you, Velvet. I'm gonna go.
Behold the arts of my ancestors! I get to style! Aaron!
Sexy.
I unleashed all my power. Maybe I overdid it.
Probably did, to be honest. I'm gonna switch you out because of it. That's your punishment, buddy. No, I'm kidding. It's more because you don't have a thing now. I don't even remember where I'm going anymore. Not the Destiny.
I'm worried.
About this whole hostage thing, you mean?
Yeah, that too. But Velvet's acting really strange.
And that's unusual how?
Moggy Lou!
Yelling at me won't change anything. Her thirst for blood knows no bounds. And she's got all the self-control of a wounded beast. With the way she's acting, I'm not sure she'll be able to escape.
She's cut her way through all her problems before. She can do it again.
I hope so. But everything has its limits. There's no blade that will not break. Nor is there such a heart. When the time comes, you'll need to make a decision. It's best you start figuring it out now.
when the time comes.
Oh, that was ominous. There's no heart that does not break. It's almost like Maggie Lou is in this to see Velvet break. Does that make sense? That makes sense.
I can fight too!
Like, it's almost like there's a part of her that's like, I just really want to see how far Velvet can go before she falls apart. Like, she kind of thought that it was going to happen in the... in Melchior's trap thing, right? So maybe now she's like... thinking it'll have, like... I think she just wants to see Velvet snap. Kind of like wanting to see that amazing painting that can only be done one time or whatever.
Another victory.
Does that make her good or bad? I guess she's really bad. Maybe she's the most baddest of everybody. I don't know. I guess it's kind of bad to say good or bad in a situation in which there's a bunch of, you know, murderous, piratey, ninja, death people, but... none of us are really princes or anything. Except Percival.
Was that supposed to be a joke?
He's gonna be a hostage, so. Not much of a prince, is he?
Whew. Well, looks like we shook off our pursuit.
Of course we did. This is the Von Eltia.
No, it can't be. This is terrible. Turn back, now!
What? There's no way we can do that.
I finally deciphered the last part of the book. If what it says is true, then Enominat is already...
the coast is clear!
All right. Let's make a break for the docks.
You're running.
It's Lord Artorias, and...
Sigure!
No, stop!
Please. Now's the time to negotiate for safe passage.
Step back, Your Highness. The girl before you wants nothing other than to kill me.
You better believe it!
This is a trap. We're leaving.
Let me go! I have to save her!
That ain't gonna happen, kid. Don't forget, you're my ticket out of here, too.
I'm not your tool! Try to stop me and I'll take you down! Even you, Aizen! Your Armatus isn't gonna stop me!
Don't worry. I have another trick up my sleeve.
That sword. Is that Orichalcum? Good job, little bro. Never seen that before.
Damn right! The hardest sword there is!
It may be made of Orichalcum,
but still...
it's time. Stand down, Shiro.
Don't be a spoil sport. I'm just starting to have fun.
Get caught in the middle of this, and even you won't survive unscathed. The one to face Velvet will be Enominat.
What?
Hello, sister. Did you miss me?
Luffy! Velvet's brother?
So that's his game. That's right. I am Lafisette Crow. And more. I am also Empyrean Innominat, the Suppressor.
No. That's... Innominat?
If you're gonna do this, you gotta commit. He's our enemy.
I know! This is just... just another illusion! I'll devour all of you! Crushing weight!
Velvet, that's what you've been doing this whole time. Struggling against all reason.
Shut up! Don't you dare pretend to be my brother! Gaze at him out! Crushing weight! Red dragon!
Oh, crap! He's so strong!
Your struggles are over. All your pain, your suffering, I'll end all of it for you.
Is this the power of an Empyrean? Exactly. This boy is Empyrean Innominat the Suppressor.
But how? We took away his strength!
By kidnapping the Therians? Sorry to burst your bubble, but you were a wee bit late. It was never about the amount of malevolence the Therians devoured. What we needed to awaken him...
was 8 different types. Greed. Conceit. Lust. Cowardice. Selfishness. Obsession. Those 6 Innominat had already obtained by the time you managed to tear the Therians away. That leaves just the 2 that Velvet carries inside her. Once Innominat has them, he will fully awaken.
And I don't even need an Earth Pulse for that. I can eat them right here.
Like hell you will! What?
If you're that weak, stay out of my way. Ow.
It's all... an illusion.
That hurts, Velvet.
Shut up! Shut up!
Are you going to kill me, sister?
Go away! Go away! Go away!
Velvet, it was always so hard for me. I was so frail. All I did was cause you trouble. Is that why? Is that why you wanted me to go away? You did.
I'm sorry, Luffy. It hurt, didn't it? Fee! Heal him, please!
But he's...
It's Luffy said! He's my brother!
But Velvet... I never wanted you to avenge me. I mean, it's that sort of selfish emotion that creates malevolence. that creates the demons.
What?
That's why I'm going to help Arthur. We're going to make all the pain in the world go away. Including that hate, that ugly malevolence in you.
Ugly malevolence?
The awakened Innominaut will suppress all negative emotions. He will remake humanity into beings free from sin.
You take away all their sins, and people aren't people anymore!
I think that's just what they intend. Like how they steal free will from the Malachim.
It will be a peaceful world, free from pain.
So your goal this whole time was to rob people of their free will?
If even an exorcist like you can let your emotions tempt you to betrayal, clearly it is the only way.
I'll make this world a safe place free from demons. That has always been my dream. Don't worry. My wounds will heal. Once I have eaten you, sister.
What's going on?
This is bad! We'll be swallowed alive!
Wait. I always... Everything I did for you. How could you do this to...
Thank you. It's because of what you've done that I need to make amends. You've hurt so many people, and all for nothing.
You can't... Avi!
Velvet!
Unfortunate.
But they're within me now. I'll find them.
A weapon can't just be hard, you know. It's gotta be flexible too, or it'll snap.
If you're addressing me, do you care to test that out?
Nah. I think I'll wait on that. At least until you and Innominaut finish up your armatization.
Shepherd Artorias! What have you done?!
It's all according to my plan, Your Highness. Let us return to the capital.
What just happened?
We were eaten by an earth pulse.
This happened to you before, didn't it?
It's different this time. It looks like our awakened friend Innominaut is using the land as his vessel. In other words, this earth pulse is now part of his body. I was able to flee him only because I found a rift in the earth pulse as it formed.
So, Velvet and the others?
I guess I won my bet. Took long enough.
Bravo! You do have a talent, if nothing else.
Oh, Melchior. If you're here, this place must be more important than I suspected.
Move aside. I must close this Earth Pulse rift.
Bianfu, protect the rift! Do well, and I'll forgive that little betrayal of yours. But if you run, my curse will follow you for eternity!
Bien! You got it!
It looks like I just won my bet. If I let you seal this rift now, I'll never collect. Illusions won't work on me. You can't break a heart that's already broken.
That day, I interrupted my art when your heart broke. I suppose I was taking pity upon my student. But this time, know that I won't hold back. I will grind your heart into dust!
You're awake! I'm glad to see you're okay. It looks like we got sucked into the Earth Pulse.
Are you all right, Eleanor? What about everyone else?
I'm fine. But...
Kill. Kill. They killed. So many. Murdered. Slaughtered. It was all for him. I killed for him, but he said I was ugly. Nothing. Nothing. All for nothing. I can't. I have to kill. Die. Die.
The whole time, she...
You're awake. Come on, we're leaving. I have to kill them.
But Enominat is your...
It's just an illusion! A fake! A trick! Or, what if it was really him? Then that means he betrayed me, doesn't it? You think I can't kill a traitor like him? Why? Why wouldn't I? Just how many do you think I've killed? You, who watched me do it!
I'm... sorry.
Velvet!
Luffy, time to wake up.
I told you to stop calling me Luffy. I'm not a little kid anymore.
Grumble, grumble, huh? You must be feeling good.
Enominat!
A bit of a fever, I'm afraid.
No, this is
at
different.
Least the new medicine's supposed to come today.
A vision of the
Until
past?
Then, you stay in bed.
See? I killed him! It was easy! I'm used to it by now. All right, we're getting out of here! With your power!
But...
Now!
We've gotta find Aizen and the rest.
I said now! Enough! Stop it! They're the ones who need to be stopped! Isn't that right? I'll kill them! I'll kill them all!
You must calm down.
Fine. I'll calm down and look for an exit. That's what you want, right?
Oh.
Whatever the case, we have to get out of here. Let's keep moving for now.
Yeah. I guess so.
Holy crap! She's like Batman and the Punisher put together, gone psycho. Oh man, I didn't think she'd get any more insane, but... And I don't even think she's insane, she's just... Wow. You know, I guess when you look at it in another way, you can say, okay, so... Artorias showed how far he is willing to push reason and logic. You know, his ideals of sacrificing the few for the many, right? Over and over again with people being sacrificed. The most recent case being both Oscar and Teresa. All in order to try to get... All that was Now I think now that we know the more of the story, like... All that was trying to kill her on an Earth Pulse. Kill Velvet on an Earth Pulse. That's really all it was, because apparently Belbit is the key to getting Anomanot completely awakened, right? So he was willing to sacrifice both of those two, completely sacrifice them in order to kill Belbit on an Earth Pulse. Then he sent his entire, not his entire, but all these armatized exorcists to another Earth Pulse base using the Therians that he didn't even care about. Even was willing to put Shigure up on the line if Shigure hadn't jumped out at the last second, all in order to kill Belbit again on an Earth Pulse area, right? So that would be his extremes to reason. But then now she has become, instead of breaking and giving up, which I think is what obviously Magilu expects to have happen, she's gone the other way and she's like embraced passion and berserkness to another extreme. Like she had kind of calmed down over the process of the game, and you're kind of like, okay, she's gonna calm down and learn that like there's a balance, and she doesn't have to, you know, she has lost, but there's still things to live for and all this kind of, no, she's just like, F you, I've lost it, we're going crazy. Oh, it's so insane. I can't handle much more of it. We gotta stop there for this episode, but we will come right back on the next one and get ourselves out of the Earth Pulse and see exactly how snapped, because that whole thing about what Magilu was saying about a broke, like, even her heart breaks at some point, like, Magilu's experience is that it breaks and then she just stops feeling things. But what if it, the case of Belbit, it broke and now she's gone to the point where she didn't not just not feel things, she feels them to the extreme. I don't know, it's kind of scary. Wow, what an episode. So much going on. That was exciting. I never saw it coming. It's really good. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time. We'll figure out what exactly is going on, because it's crazy.